Okay, welcome to Art with Jim Freeheart. I'm really glad that you're here today, and finally, I'm making my first video on my best tips for working in acrylic paints. I've been using acrylics for over 30 years, and I love them. They're my favorite kind of paint, and I have some pretty useful tips to share with you today. I'll get right to it. Keep it wet. How are you going to keep your paints wet? That's the number one challenge with acrylic paints. And there are several ways. First of all, work in the shade, if possible. This is for outdoor painting. Also, work in the early morning or later in the day when the humidity is higher. It's going to keep your paints from drying so quickly. Another thing, stay out of the sun, of course, and out of the wind. All of that helps keep the paints from drying up so quickly. You can also paint. I've painted in foggy days, and it's a dream, where I've actually done a 3 or 4 hour painting, and everything ends up wet and wet, just like an oil painting. But it'll dry as soon as you get it indoors. It'll dry, so it's a fabulous condition to be able to paint in. If you're working indoors, simple. Buy a good humidifier or two. Put them in the room you're going to be working in, run the humidifier for an hour or so before you're going to paint, and it'll transform your painting experience. It'll be like a foggy day and give you a lot more time for your mixing of your paints. Use a water spray bottle, like so. That felt good. I don't use it to spray on my paints because what happens if your paints are half dry and you, on your painting itself, it'll sort of slightly dissolve the paints and you try and brush any more on there, all these spots will appear where the paint got wet and you just brushed it off with another brushing with your paintbrush. So I use it to mist my palettes. Covered palette is the next tip anyway. So here it is. Here's a covered of a well-used palette. And here is my palette that, these are all paints that I buy from my supplier. And I'll describe the paints I use. But you may notice I use really intense, vibrant colors. There's a reason for that. You can never resurrect a muddy paint by adding bright paints to it. It's already a mess. It's already muddy. So what I do is I buy those vibrant paints from my art store, and then I mix my own palette of colors that I'm going to use frequently in my painting. So it lets me paint much more quickly. I've already mixed a number of my popular favorite colors that I use, and when I am in the process of painting, I can paint really quickly. I just grab the paints right out of the little bin and slap it on the canvas, and I'll even do some mixing on the canvas. I'll grab a few colors and put them on and mix them on my canvas sometimes. Anyway, let's see. The covered palette is the best thing imaginable, and I will also take my spray bottle and mist inside the palette and mist my paints many times throughout a painting session. Not too much that you end up with a lake in there, just enough to keep things from drying up. From time to time when you're painting, if you're going to take a few minutes break or you're not using or you're doing some fine detail, just mist your paints and cover them just for a couple of minutes. It'll let them start to soften and dissolve if they're starting to get a little dry apart on top of the paint. The other thing that I do is I use a really wonderful paint. Golden Open Acrylics. I love golden paints. They're really high quality paints, number one. And use the open acrylics are the ones that dry slowly and give me lots more mixing time. If you don't use that particular brand of paint, you can use high-slow or a retarding medium, a painting medium that you mix in with your paints. Personally, I don't have the patience to do that with all my paints, so I buy them already mixed like that, and these are fabulous paints anyway. The other thing I do is I work quickly using big brushes. I got some pretty good sized brushes that I start with for doing my undercoating, because I almost always coat a canvas with paint just to get rid of the white canvas. Here are my paintbrushes. I use a brush that's called a Bright. A Bright is a relatively short, relatively flat brush. Now you can see, like on some of these, look how, here's a good example. It's a really broad bristle this way, but turn it sideways and it's super fine. So I can get some really nice details. Here's my tofu container for water. It's a nice shallow little pan, but rather than a deep jar where you get your paints standing in there pointing and messing up the bristles on your brush, that's another way to do it. So here we go. Last couple of tips. Let's see. The brushes, by the way, I use, they're synthetic bristles. For acrylic paints, they're better than a natural bristle, in my experience. And this particular brand is called Pro Stroke. But there are a lot of different choices. This is one that I like quite a bit. Here's my palette knife, too. I kind of like this style of palette knife rather than the traditional style. But that's just a personal thing. Another thing, how can you keep your paints from drying out? Paint quickly. So how do I do that? I set a timer sometimes, or I find myself an hour before sunset and I'm setting up painting and knowing that I'm going to lose my light in an hour and a half. I won't even be able to do anything more. So I do that. I also use large brushes. I push myself to use something a little bit bigger than I'm really easily comfortable with, and it works out really well. So here's an example. I was at the beach one day. I saw the most extraordinary clouds, and I had about probably 45 minutes before the sun was going to set, and I thought, can I do it? So I grabbed a huge 30 by 40 canvas. I do mostly bigger sizes out on plein air, and here was a really quick painting that I did in about an hour or something like that. I did come back and touch it up a little bit later, but anyway, there you go. So really quick, broad strokes, and it made a really nice painting that had a lot of movement and life to it. So one of the last things, have fun. Hopefully the reason you're doing this is because you love to paint. Once you really get into it, you just get so passionate about it, you can forget everything else in the world. It's like a meditation. And just have a wonderful time. When you're done with your painting, I really encourage you to look at the painting and look for the parts that you really like, that captured what you were hoping to capture. That will be really useful, because instead of looking for all the parts you don't like, look for the ones you do. You want to remember those and duplicate that kind of feeling in another painting. So I'm going to turn this around, because I don't know if this is all backwards, I think. So I'll try and take a picture of this and put it on my on with this video. Anyway, Art with Jim Freeheart. Thanks for visiting with me today. Hope you have a beautiful day. Please take a moment and subscribe. And if you enjoyed the tutorial, let me know. And I hope you do really well. Have a great time painting. It's a lot of fun. Bye.